Hello everybody, my name is Kevin and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, this is a series that I like to call Badger Bits. It is a short form vlogging series about my life. I will film all the way through a month and then cut it all down and make it into a vlog. This is something that I tried back in 2020. I managed to do January and February before the whole pandemic and the lockdown happened. So it kind of got put on hold for a very long time. I've decided to restart this to help with my own mental health and to just document things that are happening in my life so I can see how my life is improving, all the positive things, and just so I have something for myself to help me. I will also bring around to any bad things that will happen in my life as well. I won't just cut that out because I want to show that my life is both positive and negative at the moment. I'm still having a lot of trouble with my mental health, as I've just said. My depression and anxiety are still quite high. The pandemic didn't help with that. I end up feeling a lot more isolated. It's only taken the last year and a half, maybe 2 years, that I've finally been able to go out again and see people without feeling panicked. After the whole pandemic thing stopped and we were allowed to go back out again, I became very insular. I didn't like going out and seeing people. I didn't initiate meeting up with people because I just felt very internal. So that is something I'm working on. Some of the things that have changed in the last 3 years since I did a video like this include my, as you can see, I'm a lot bigger than I used to be. Back when I was filming before, I was talking about losing weight. I found that I was a lot more sad and depressed about my physical body. I was having a lot of body dysmorphia. I did not like being thin or muscular. And now that I have put on weight, I am a lot bigger. But I'm happy. I like the way I look. I've had a few people in my life not like this. I've had a few comments about my weight, but I am happy and I am healthy. I have regular checkups with the doctor over a multitude of different things that are wrong with me. But my weight isn't a problem because of those things. I still suffer from sciatica, which is the pain in my back and my leg. That was a injury I got before I put on weight. During COVID as well, I did get COVID-19 myself. And when I got it, it severely damaged my bowels. So I now have to, I now suffer from severe IBS. This is something that I'm starting to cope with now. I'm on medications, I'm on a specific diet. But yeah, any health problems that I have nothing to do with my size, my weight. So you don't have to worry about that. So, on to a more positive thing. A couple of years ago, I took over the Monster Mash Teas company from my cousin Suzie. I've been running it now for nearly 3 years. It is going slow but steady. I'm hoping it will grow and that future projects will be coming up. I do have a Sci-Fi Scarborough that I'm going to this year and hopefully it will go well. Some of the other things that have been going on in my life are my family. My dad a few years ago was diagnosed with kidney failure, so he now is on dialysis. He has been for a few years. It was a shock to see him deteriorate as fast as he did. The way he looked when he started to where he looks now, I think he looks a lot better. But we know this is a terminal thing. Myself and the rest of the family are preparing for the day when we have to say goodbye, which is really sad. Hopefully he isn't in too much pain when that happens, but we have been hanging out a lot more. We've been talking a lot more. We had a very long emotional conversation about the way we've been treating each other in our lives, and we have found a new stable way to be around each other and talk to each other. So you will see videos on here of when I go see him. We go play pool, we go for meals, we go for a drink, we hang out, we talk, and it's good that we're having that. It's bad that it's will be at the end of his life, but it's good that we've finally come to an equilibrium in the way we speak to each other. Another thing as well that happened is my brother ended up staying with me for a while. There was something that happened which meant that I had to look after him for a while. In doing that, me and my brother have been able to have our conversation about our life, about our upbringing, and we have also found a nice equilibrium of what we were once told as children, the lies we were told, and now moving forward with the truth of what was what happened as kids. I'm sorry. My new kitty here is wanting some attention. So say hello, Milo. I'll tell you a lot about Milo later on. So go on then. So yeah, me and my brother are speaking, and at the moment he's living with my dad, which is good because he gets to look after my dad. My dad also gets to help him. He's got a brand new job, and going forward, we have a relationship again, which is great. I'm happy that we've actually got to that point in our lives where we can actually be a family again, really. In other family news, my cousin Susie had to go back into hospital again for another operation on her leg. She found that the original operation she had when she lost her leg was fumbled. They made so many mistakes, which meant she's been in pain for so long. But now she's had a brand new operation. She's going through her healing process. She is making her own videos on her recovery. I will link it in the description below if you want to watch that. Warning, she does show the state of what her leg used to look like and where it looks now. So there are some graphic videos. If you're not really into that, then she will tell you to look away when she shows that. But she is wanting to use this year for recovery, and then hopefully next year she will be doing a charity climb of Ben Nevis, which is something she wanted to do for so long. I myself are wanting to get a little bit more active in my life, get a little bit more fitter, and I'm hoping if everything goes well, I might join her. So we'll see how that goes. That's not a promise. As you just saw before, we have a new cat in the house called Milo. We got him last year. We got him mainly because our other cat Gizbo was suffering once again with cancer a few years beforehand, back in 2021, I think it was. He got a lump on his shoulder, which they found out was cancer. They had it removed, and he had a slow recovery, but he was starting to get better. And then a new lump was found at the bottom of his throat, which kind of knocked him down a peg. He became very slow, very lethargic. And we knew that if he passed away and then Emery would be alone, our other cat Emery. So we decided to get a new kitten, so that if Gizbo passed away, then Emery would have someone else to play with. This actually brought more life back into Gizbo for a short while. He was playing, he was teaching the new kitten how to hunt, how to play. But unfortunately, we had to make the decision eventually to say goodbye to him, as the pain was getting way too much for him and he was slowly leaving us. This took a lot out of me because Gizbo has always been my, what I call my emotional support animal, even though he wasn't trained in any way like that. He was always by my side. He would sleep with me in bed and cuddle with me when I was feeling down and sad and depressed and anxious. So his death really hit me hard. I'm still, it's been, it was October when he passed away, so it's been a few months now. And it still hurts to think about it. It still hurts to talk about him. I do miss him. But we do have Emery still, and we now have the Milo. The Emery and Milo didn't quite get on at first, because Emery was used to being the baby. And now they've come to a bit of an agreement themselves. They now play with each other, they go out together. I've seen them sleep with each other, which is fun, because usually when I find them laying next to each other and I turn up, one of them just moves. And it's like, nope, I wasn't there. Nope, everything's fine. Nope. So I'm glad that Emery now has a little brother to keep him company. But yeah, it's still sad that we've lost Gizbo. Yeah. Other things that have happened in my life is a few of my friends have left my life. A couple of friends have joined my life. This is something that happens when you tend to get older. People come and go all the time. Some of the friendships ended badly, some did not. Some ended with just them moving away. I did lose a few friends during COVID, because of illness, which is not good. But I now have a brand new set of close friends, which I hang out a lot. You will see them in the videos coming up. You all met Vincent way back when I was doing videos beforehand. He's still in my life. You've met Benji once before when we did the sibling rivalry tour, which is the picture there when he came to watch the Bob the Drag Queen and Money Exchange with me. I now also have a friend called Geller who is becoming very close friend as well. He comes and hangs out with us, plays games with us. We go out for meals and stuff like that. It's nice to have this close friendship now with these people. I do have other friends as well that I hang around with. I've got people I do my other role-playing games with. I've got people who I go to events with. But the ones you will mainly see on this channel will be them. So That's life. Everything happens. Friends come and go, and you have to deal with it. So, yeah. Speaking of friends, the Penny Dreadfuls game that you have seen here on this channel before, run by my cousin Susie, we paused the game during the whole COVID, and now we've restarted it. So we've technically been playing this game now for about 4 or 5 years. In game, we're on day 7. I think it could be day 7 or day 8. So a lot. The way the game is ran, we are every minute in game is a minute in game. So if we've only done something, if we've only gone somewhere and spoke to someone, that will be like 10 minutes in the world. So a lot of things can happen in a day. So that's why the days are very long when it comes to the world. The character I play knows that it's been a lot longer than 7 to 8 days because he remembers every single day. And when we restarted after COVID, Susie made it so that my character remembered every day, every 7 seconds that the world was resetting for every day we didn't play during COVID. So that was like 3 years worth of resetting of a day. So that was fun and unusual to play. I'm having a lot of fun with that, and I hope that it continues. And I hope we actually get to play a lot more. With Susie's recoveries, we're on break at the moment. We're hoping to get back into playing in about March, April time. So I will put up videos of that when it comes to that. Another role-playing thing, Richard's nephew Joseph, who has been on this vlog before when he was a lot younger, is now a teenager in college, which makes me feel very old, asked me to run a D&D game for him, which I'm having fun doing. I've ran a few games before. Usually they're very short form. They tend to fizzle out after a couple of sessions. This one's been going on nearly a year now. It started with Joseph and Richard just playing the game, and eventually I added my friend Gala, because Joseph wanted to meet new people, and I thought Gala would be a good person for him to join. And then my friend Benji decided to join us as well, so I now have 4 players. They are doing a Spelljammer campaign, which they are nearly finishing. So when we've actually finished the campaign, they get to decide then if I'm starting a brand new campaign with them or if they're going to carry on with the characters. Some of the actions that they have done are quite fun. Joseph himself is multi-classed. He started off as a bard, then he became a ranger, and then he became a sorcerer. He's got a multitude of animals that he gets on. He has a wolf, he's a hamster, he has a bat. So keeping him contained is a bit of a struggle sometimes, but with Richard's help, with his character bouncing off of him, it's been going well. Richard is playing a barbarian sorcerer, which is a very strange mix. Gala is playing a warlock who, after making a deal with his patron, has now become a demon bunny because he was a harrigan, which is a bunny type of creature, and now he's more demon as well, so that's a fun thing. And then with Benji, he's playing a owlin druid, so he's playing an owl, and he's just I've just done his background stuff in game, which he's enjoying, and he's trying to figure everything out. So in the next, either what would be the first game of February, There should be at least three more sessions before the campaign ends. When it does, I will tell you about it. You'll see clips on here as well from the games. And yeah, it's been fun doing this, being a DM, because I get to create this world. I get to tell these stories, and it helps me unwind. It helps me get out of my own head. Playing the Independent Dreadfuls as well does the same thing. I get to be somebody else for a short while. So I don't have to think about what's going on in my life for a short time. It's very therapeutic. So, yeah. So anyway, this is the rest of January. I hope you enjoy them. Coming up is my friend Vincent's birthday, where we did a multitude of activities. Me and Richard went on another date, which is something we're going to be doing at least once a month. We have a jar of different things that we're going to do, that we pick a one out every month, and we're going to do that. This time was going out for a meal. So yeah, enjoy the month. Bye.
How so long? Come on today.
Oh, they're right, these are ours, sorry.
What,
have you had a few to go to the bar?
Just see how that one doesn't work.
That one doesn't work.
That's broken.
Yeah, you can have that. Thanks.
No thanks.
Thank you.
Time for some IKEA food.
Happy birthday, Vincent.
What's this game called?
Overcooked, I think.
Overcooked too.
Oh, is he good?
Can everyone get this game?
There's a fire. There's a fire next to me. Who's got the...
There's no fire except for the
joint.
Let's go out.
Okay. That was a horrible one. Oh! Mum's got entrapment. Lettuce is there. That's to go out. Pickle. I need lettuce on that plate. Oh!
Did we just die?
We've landed somewhere. Right, yeah. So I need lettuce on this plate here.
Right, okay, so what's the fucking chopping board's got
here? Yeah. And then that needs to go out.
Okay.
And then we need pickle.
Okay.
Right, I'll do prep. You do.
I'm washing.
Yeah, you take out.
You need to tell me when it's done.
That needs to go. That tomato. Oh, freaking hell. I threw a tomato off. Right, and then lettuce. Out you go. Plate. Thank you. Oh, I don't need you. I need you. Out.
I spent months asking you what we're doing for the weather's been.
Out.
Where am I?
I need sushi.
There you go.
Oh, right, I already had it. There we go.
Sorry, dude.
And you? So I need rice and a pickle.
Rice needs to be on the cook. Okay.
Yeah. Where's the fish?
It's on the conveyor belt on the top.
Well, it's on that side, yeah, right there. Come here, yeah. Come here, you fish, thank you. Look at your fish, thank you.
Okay, let it rise, there you go.
Thank you, that one needs to go out. This needs a
plate.
And then... Where's the abs? Just there. Right, so plates. That one was very
stressful. Did pretty well though. Yeah, okay.
Zero order sales.
Yeah, I'm very happy with that.
I'm gonna go to the hospital. Mini goal for the boys.
I just did a quick video.